It's now time for my review of Rutschebanen in Tivoli Gardens. This is one of my personal favorite coasters, so it really deserves a review, I think. So that's what it's going to get now. Rutschebanen is an old classic scenic railway. It's more than 100 years old. And it is still running beautifully smooth today, so that's great. So in this review, first I'm going to talk about what I like about the coaster, and talk about some stats. Then I'm going to talk over a point of view of the ride. I'm going to give you my 5 favorite elements, talk about them, and I'm going to give it a score out of 10 in the last part of the video. So Rutschebanen is 18 meters tall, it is 720 meters long. I believe it goes somewhere between 50 and 60 kilometers an hour, but this is just an average speed, because it has a brake man, so you can't really say the exact speed of the ride. And the model is a Waldemar Lebec Scenic Railway. So Rutschebanen is one of those where it's most of the good things about the ride is about the atmosphere around it. Such an impressive thing that they just keep this coaster so good today, while it's just so old. I mean, it's the smoothest wooden coaster in Denmark, and we have one that's only over 15 years old. So that's impressive. And it has some really, really good eject airtime and some good laterals, which is the good things about the ride for me. So it's one of the routes that had this really, really fast chain lift. And you have a beautiful view for Copenhagen here and from the park, which is beautiful too. And all the drops, the first one like all the other ones, give some really good eject airtime. I will suggest you go in the back, because when you get pulled over all the drops, this turn gives some good laterals if a brakeman does his job well. This is the biggest drop, but that doesn't mean the best. I'm going to talk about top 5 elements later, so that you can see how much I like it compared to the other ones. You get some good laterals again here, and some good eject airtime through this drop, and a beautiful view too. That's something you don't want to forget about this ride, the view. And here you get some good laterals first to the left and then smash against to the right. No, sorry, the opposite way. This is a really good aggressive drop, and this is a good atom hill too. And then you go into the dark and you have some turns that get some good laterals, and you can actually see the track above you when you after the turn. You can see where it was. You can't in this video because it's too dark, but if you are on the ride yourself, you will see it there. So this is the end of a beautiful, unique ride. It's one of those, I like it in another way than I do on some of my other favorite coasters. And it is one of my favorite coasters, actually. I rank it really high. So yeah, now it's time to talk about my favorite elements of the ride. Number 5, I have the first drop. Like I say, you get some good airtime. But not as good as the next element, which is the second drop. This is the biggest drop, and it's pretty much as aggressive as the first one, but it's longer, so that's just why it's one spot above. So next up, I have the third drop. So you see, the drops get more and more aggressive, which is great. Here you get some really good aggressive airtime, and you have some good laterals just before it, which means you kind of get laterals and airtime at the same time. Next up, I have the last drop. So this is probably the shortest one, but you have so much speed taking the drop, which means if you are in the back seat, you will get some insane eject airtime. Number 1 is the last little bunny airtime hill. That is actually, it looks really good in the POV in the front row, but it's much better in the back. In the front, you just get a quick pop of ejector, but in the back you will get ejector just from you at the top of the hill, so you are at the bottom again, and you get actually pretty crazy standing airtime if you have the right brake man. So yeah, now for final score. There is one flaw about this ride, which is sometimes you get a bad ride because not all the brake mans does it as well as the other ones. So I can give it a perfect score, but it wouldn't get a 10 out of 10 anyways, because it's not the level of coasters like Canon and Helix and Hyperion leg coasters like them. So I'm going to give Rutschebanen an 8 out of 10. I love this ride, but I just can't give it a perfect score, even though I wish I could, because I have so much respect for how they just keep this ride going, and they do the job about this ride beautifully. So it is absolutely one of my personal favorites, but I can't give it a 10 out of 10. Thank you for watching this review. I hope you enjoy it. Bye.